2 weeks ago, it was this, the simha of my son. And I was thinking something. A lot of people, he got married in Parashat Balak. In Parashat Balak, people, you know, you haven't been there, so I know he studied Torah with you, Meir, and I want to tell you, a lot of people, they saw the Shekhinah it was in under the Chuppah. It was a big Shekhinah. And that week it was Parashat Balak. As you know, in Parashat Balak, there is something incredible. Balak was a big Rasha, yes or no? We agree?
Yeah.
It was a mamzer. It was a Rasha, big Rasha. I did not understand what the Torah had to talk to him about him in the Parasha. I don't care. There is so many people, they are Rishaim, and the Torah don't talk about them. But why Bilam the Torah talk about him? Who cares that he wanted to curse the Jews? Everybody wants to curse the Jews. Balak, he was afraid of the Jews. They might fight him. All nations, they were afraid of the Jews. We did not talk about all nations in the Torah. What only about Balak and Bilam? Only, I think, the Torah wants to give us a demonstration, something to teach, to learn for life. Even that Balak and Bilam, they hate the Jews. They hate the Jews. Like, Bemet, last week I was reading the parasha, and Balak, every time, he said to Bilam, maybe from that place you can curse the Jews. And then Balak, Bilam, what he did, don't tell me, he started to bless the Jews.
Yeah.
So Balak, he got angry. So Balak, he got angry. Hey, Bilam, I told you to curse the Jews, you bless the Jews. I told you, Bilam answered. I told you that I cannot say only what Hashem wants. Okay, so let's go to that place. Maybe from there, Hashem, he will love to curse the Jews. So Bilam, okay, let's go there. Okay, can you build here some mizbehot? We will do some sacrifice to Hashem. And then Hashem said to Bilam, Bilam, don't curse the Jews, bless them. Whatever I tell you, tell. Then Balak, he got angry. Bilam, I told you to curse the Jews, not to bless the Jews. Okay. So, you know what? Don't bless them. Don't curse them, but don't bless them. And then Balak, he changed his mind. He said, maybe we go to that place. Maybe from there, God, Hashem will love you to curse the Jews. And then, again, Bilam, they would go there, they built Mikdashim, Mizbeot, and instead of cursing, what he do?
Blessing.
And among the blessing, he said something incredible. Ma tuvu o'alecha Yaakov, mishkinu tuch Yisrael. Oh, Jews, you are fantastic. Oh, Jews, how you build your home, how is your marriage, how is your Torah? And the Rashi said, Natan libo levarichotam. That moment, really, Bilam, he wanted to bless them. On one hand, he wanted to do an emara, but on the other hand, he was amazed. He saw the emet. He saw the truth, that the Jews are emet.
100%.
It was 100%. So I don't understand. Now, and then he said, Matu alecha. Bilam, now that you saw the emet, now that you bless them, now that you saw how the Jews are fantastic, why he give a bad advice to Balak to send them women to do with them averot, sin, and then Hashem will punish them? I mean, if I see that you're emet, why I have to send mafia to kill you? If I know that you're the best. Up to now, I thought you are a bad man. Now that I know that you're Emmet, you're truly, you're right, you're fantastic, how can I send you people to kill you? Understand?
This is the question.
And besides it, I don't understand Balak, that every time Balak is to Bilam, maybe from that case, Hashem would love you to curse them. But Balak, Bilam, you know that Hashem from the beginning, he told you not to curse. Not every time. So why every time you want to curse them? But you know that Hashem don't want you to curse them. You understand? If you know that I don't want you to eat this taref, why every time you ask me, can I eat it? I told you it's forbidden, you cannot eat it. Again, can I eat it? No! Understand? From here, understand one thing. Please listen to this. That wedding of my son, I'm sure that Rabbi Hanpidu was there. All the tzaddikim were there. Why? Because he's the only one, Bemet, that all the time he studied Torah. You go in the yeshiva in the morning, he's the first. And the last, he's the one. When people at 1 o'clock go to eat, and they go to rest a little bit, he's there. He eats 5 minutes, he starts to eat Torah. Torah is food. Torah is food for him.
Mary's like that, but he likes food too.
And then, people finish at 5 o'clock to go home, he's there. Even the week of Sheva Brachot, that he was supposed to be with his wife, Sheva Brachot, most of the day was in the yeshiva, studying Torah. And to wake up early as usual, as he is not married. So, I was thinking, this is what Bilam HaRasha saw. He saw how Jewish people, all their life is Torah. He was a big Navi, he was a prophet, Bilam. He saw people, and he saw the wives helping the husband to study Torah. All their life is Torah. Think Torah. Sleeping with Torah. Wake up with Torah. Walking ובלכתך בדרך ובתורה. ובשוכבך ובתורה. ובקומך ובתורה. He saw ממש the respecting the קריאת שמע. We see קריאת שמע על המיטה before we sleep, we see קריאת שמע before we go to bed. What that mean? What that mean?
Why do we say קריאת שמע?
Why we say על המיטה? קריאת שמע, did you say in the bed? You know why? Because when you have to sleep, you have to sleep with Torah. You wake up, Modeh Ani Lefanecha, it's Torah. You walk in the street, Torah. You listen to that CD in the car. You travel, Torah. That's what Bilam saw. Bilam saw life of a Jew and the life of somebody that is not Jewish. Rabbi Yosef Pinto, he's a big tzaddik. I think he's the one who is buried, or Marrakesh, or Ouarzazate. He's a big tzaddik. I saw something incredible that he said. He said, what's the difference between a Jew and a non-Jew? He said, a Jew, he knows that he's not allowed to eat not kosher in the street. He knows not allowed to eat not kosher in the house. So now, maybe in the house he will keep it. In the street he will not keep it, maybe. But when he sees Jewish people, so he will not eat because of them. Because if he eat of them, they will scream at him. They will say, hey, it's not kosher. Understand? Understand me? I mean, can you imagine a Jew doing a sin in front of people? He will not do it. Because everybody will attack him. But a non-Jew, there is nothing to be ashamed of. But everybody don't eat kosher. Everything is free. There is no limit. I mean, except don't kill, don't steal. But we talk about kashrut, we talk about nida. A goy, a non-Jew, he can touch his wife when she has a period. He can even have a relationship with her if he wants. But a Jew, no. It's forbidden. So you understand? That's what Bilam saw. I think that's what Bilam saw. Bilam, you know what he saw? He saw that the Jewish people have a life according to the Torah. They live with the Torah. They sleep with the Torah. I mean, even to eat, there is law. To finish eating, there is law, Birkat Hamazon. If it's each move that you do, you have to be according to the Torah. All your life is Torah. Business, you have to be honest. Don't curse. Don't curse. Don't lie. That was Bilam saw. And he was amazed. At the beginning, he did not know all this. It's like a lot of, you know, Jewish people, when they talk to me, they said, Rabbi, before I thought I was anti-Semite, before I thought, you Jews, you are monkeys. You Jews, you are a donkey. You Jews, you are stealing, capitalist, this thing. When I get to know the Jewish people really, I see that you are good people. We did not know you. So we understand Bilam. At the beginning, Bilam thought the Jews are donkeys, the Jews are this. But now that he saw, really, he opened his eyes and he saw the Jew that all their life is Torah. Like my son Michael, that all the time he studied Torah, he live with the Torah, he sleep with the Torah, he wake up with the Torah. So, and Bilam saw that all the Jews were like that. So he started to bless them. So the question is, why after he blessed them, he give a bad advice to Balak? You understand? Why? And the other question was, why Balak every time he said to Bilam, let's change the place, maybe from there Hashem, he will accept that you curse them. The answer is that Balak, he didn't want to take a chance. He said to Bilam, maybe, in the meantime that you will choose the place, the Jews will do Avera, so do you curse them. Hashem, we don't want you to curse them here. Maybe in another place he will let you curse them, because in the meantime, the Jews did one Avera. So let's take an advantage that they did Avera, you curse them, the curse will do a... And Bilam, he believed it. So why Bilam? After all what you saw, why you wanted to curse them? You know why? A man without Torah will never understand somebody who studied Torah. Yeah. I can see you study Torah, I will be amazed. Oh, it's fantastic, it's beautiful. Look this young boy, look this gentleman. They love Torah, fabulous. And then he will give a good donation. But once he's out, why I give them so much money for those people? Why they don't want to go to work? Why they're sitting there all day? To understand Torah, you have to study Torah. To understand the Ben Torah, you have to study. That's why there is Yisachar and Zvulon. Why there is what do we learn from Yisachar and Zvulon? Zvulon, Yisachar is sitting in the Torah. Who support him? Zvulon. But what is Zvulon, he can say, oh, I'm fed up to support him. But if he studied Torah as well, he will be happy to support all the time. But if he will not study Torah, he will stop to support. I'm telling you that I know thousands of people, they supported me before, only when they have problems. But when they have no problems, they forgot about me. They come back to me when they have problems again. Why? Because they don't know the value of the Torah. To support me all the time, only if they study Torah. Because they know the value of the Torah. Why among the Hasidim always they support Torah? Why the Rita'im always they support Torah? Because they study Torah. But unfortunately, we, the Sfaradim, not all of them study Torah. So, and we have a rich people. We have a lot of rich people.
Yeah.
They don't give ma'aser. And they don't, why did they support, why did they not support? Why one day yes, why they not? Because they don't study Torah.
It's true.
If they study, that is the lesson of Bilam. That's why the Torah put this in the Torah. Why the Torah wrote this history of Bilam, the Torah, to teach you. Bilam was a prophet. Bilam, he knew everything was going on in the Shamayim. Bilam was a fabulous man. He was whatever he cursed, whatever he blessed, it's blessed. When he cursed, it's cursed. Everything, it was like Moshe Rabbeinu. He was even more than Moshe Rabbeinu. So what happened to him? Why he was a bad person? Even when he realized that the Jews are good, why he was a bad person? You know why? Because he didn't want to get involved in the Torah. If only he will, he saw the Jews, how they live. Okay, test it. Do like what Rut did. Do like what Yitro did. Yitro was his friend. Do like all those convert people, that like Rabbi Akiva, Rabbi Meir. They, I saw in one book that Rabbi Meir Baranes, he was the son of the Neron, the emperor of Rome. Because Neron, he became Jew. He converted himself, and his son was Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Meir Baranes. He was the son of a converted man. Yes, sir.
You do? Yeah, he was the son of a Meir. I didn't know that.
He was the son of the emperor.
Wow.
Look, Ancyros. He was the nephew of Adrianus the emperor, and he became a holy man. When you study the Torah, the Torah changed you. Bilam, instead of being bad man, bad, he could change if he wanted. Just if he wanted. If he wanted. But he didn't want. You know, yesterday, this week, somebody told me, somebody was very happy because I helped him. He told me, Rabbi, whatever you want, I give you. I looked at him, I told him, what do you want to give me? What can you give me? He said, whatever you want. I said, like what? Like what? Tell me what, whatever, what, like what? He said, if you want a favor, if you want a good tzedakah. So, I said, good tzedakah. Okay. I said, you want a good tzedakah? You want to give a good tzedakah, okay? Okay. What a good tzedakah. He's a billionaire, this man. Billionaire. He said, if you want a few thousand. I said, a few thousand? A few hundred thousand? A few hundred million? Of your what? 2,600 dollars. I looked at him. I told him, look, you give whatever you want. But one thing I want to tell you, you don't value the Torah. After all what Hashem did for you, you don't value the Torah. Because if you value the Torah, after all what Hashem did for you, you will not talk like that. And he understood. This is people. I mean, you need a ratzon, la volonté, love Torah. Value Torah. Now I finish. I have to tell a story. Instead, I was happy. I received a beautiful letter. Somebody that after the bracha that she got, she had no children, not at all. And she became pregnant, Baruch Hashem, big emunah, and she had two babies. She wrote me the I will send you the facts. You'll be happy. And then she wrote me there, please Rabbi David, now we are ready. We want another two. I mean, this is Emuna.
Yeah.
I mean, she said, it's like you go to bakery then you order bagels. You eat the bagels, they're good. I want another two bagels. Emuna. That's Emuna. Bilaam, he was prophet. Why did not have Emuna? You're a prophet. Where's Hashem? In your history, where? No, he's not Hashem. You know why? Because Bilaam, he was Rasha. He only wanted what is good for him. He didn't want what is not good for him. So that's Hashem. I pray for you that Hashem give you bracha, etzlacha, bi'ut, parnasa tova, and all your problems will be out.
حيم بنتو وقف لنا زي خطوط